Curious what's been happening in the Milton real estate market? Well, if you are, then this video is for you. I'm Shaleni Henriquez with RE/MAX Real Estate Center, and your time is valuable. So over the next minute or so, we're going to break down what's been happening in the Milton real estate market for May 2021, and also what's been happening into June. So stick with us for the next minute or so, where we're going to give you some tips and advice on how to navigate this market. The May stats are in, and our local real estate market is
hot, hot, hot.
That song makes me want to dance. I don't know about you. It makes me think of summer. And we are heading into summer. And Milton real estate is still quite hot. Now, there were some slight changes this month from last month. Some prices went up, some prices went slightly down. We're going to cover all of that right now. Our months of inventory is slightly changed at 0.7 months. Now, if you watched the video from last month, we were at 0.6 months of inventory across all home types. That is still a very hot, hot, hot seller's market, and homes are not lasting very long on the market. In May, across all home types, we had 310 home sales across all home types. Now, that's slightly down from what we had in April, where we had 342 home sales, and it's also down from March, where we had a whopping 427 home sales. So there's a gradual decline happening in home sales. And that happens generally as we get into some of the summer months. So you may see it trend down a little bit. Generally over summer, it can be a little bit flat, and then we tend to go up again in the fall. Now, overall sales are still way up this year. We're sitting at 1,508 home sales year to date in Milton. Mind you, I've said it before and I'll say it again. Last year, real estate was essentially at a virtual standstill with everything that was happening with COVID and the lockdowns. It really wasn't until the end of May last year that we really started to see things picking up. Now, our average home sale across all home types is now $1,062,600. Now, that is the highest that it's been year to date. Now, our average days on market in May was 9, and that's the same as what we had in April across all home types. As well, our average sale price to list price ratio for May was 105%, where in April it was at 107%, so a slight decline there. What that stat indicates is, on average across all home types, this particular one, how much more were homes selling for than what they were listed for. And in May it was 105%, so buyers were paying on average 5% more than the asking price. Put that in context for you. If a home was listed for $500,000, which there aren't very many homes in Milton, but just to make the math easy, if a home was listed for $500,000, on average, buyers were paying an extra $25,000 on top of the price that the home was listed for. One of the interesting things I noticed in May is that some home categories, the price went down. So if you were looking for detached homes in Milton, the price was slightly down. If you were looking at semi-detached homes in Milton, the price was slightly down. If you were looking at condos in Milton, the price was slightly down. But if you were looking for townhomes in Milton, the price was up. Could that have something to do with the stress test increase that came in that's pushed more people down into that townhome price point category? We will see. We'll see what happens in June. What I notice now, we're partway into June. What's been happening in Milton real estate are, especially if you're looking in townhomes, there's still a lot of offer nights set up where we'll have multiple offers on homes. There are still, you know, homes that are selling preemptively. So on bully offers, that's still happening. Well, I was in multiples yesterday. There were 6 offers on a townhome property here in Milton. So townhomes are definitely a hot commodity locally in Milton right now. Some of the detached, especially the larger detached homes, once we get over that, you know, 1.3, 1.4, I've seen some of those not selling on offer nights. People have been canceling those, or they've listed low and not got what they wanted. Now they've relisted at a higher price, which always shocks people when I tell them that that happens. If you're not actively in the market and you hear about that, it really sounds bizarre. Wait, they were asking $999 and now they're asking $1.2? What's going on? Well, that is just how it's been working around here, especially I would say over the last year. A lot of list low, multiple offers, and then selling for more money. So that's why, again, it's really important that you are working with a local Milton real estate agent like myself that really understands the market, because it can save you a lot of time. There are homes that are listed. There's one, for example, right now, one townhome listed very, very low in town. It's going to sell for, like, because that exact same model sells for much, much more, like almost $200,000 more for what they have this particular one listed for, and they're holding it back on offer. So, you know, if you wanted to go out and see that home, I'd almost say, you know, this is not gonna sell in the range that you're looking for. It's more likely to sell in this upper range. And if that's not a range that you wanna be in, then you can save yourself an outing and going to see something that's just not gonna work for you. Now, if you have questions about Milton real estate, if you're thinking about getting into Milton, moving here, if you wanna know what some of the neighborhoods are like, what might be a great neighborhood for you, if you're looking for newer homes or older homes, if you want property, then just send me a message. I'm happy to have a conversation with you. You know, I've been in Milton for 17 years. We've lived in various neighborhoods across Milton. I love it here, raised my kids here. I have my family here. My husband's a contractor, runs a fantastic business here. We would love to help you and bring you into our community. So next week, I am going to be taking you on a tour of some of Milton's neighborhoods so that you can get to know them a little bit better, all from the comfort of your own home. If you have any other videos you'd like to see about Milton or questions, put it in the comments below and let me know. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the little bell so you never miss out on one of our great episodes. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next week.